Next paper, the title is Efficacy and Safety of Oral Hydroxyurea in Patients with Transfusion-Dependent Beta Thalassemia, a Randomized, Double-Blinded, Placebo-Controlled Clinical Trial. The paper is authored by Yasara N, Vikramaratna N, Silva I, Hamid N, Attanayake AMKR, Jayasingha VL, Vikramasingha N, Rodrigo R, Pereira L, Mettananda KCD, Manamperi A, Premavardhana A, Mettananda S. And the paper will be presented by Yasara N.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Today I'm here to present the outcome of the randomized double-blind placebo-controlled clinical trial I have conducted to assess the efficacy and safety of oral hydroxyurea in transfusion-dependent beta thalassemia patients. As you all aware, beta thalassemia is one of the most common genetic disorders in the world, but the only existing cure is allogeneic hematopoietic stem cell transplantation, but it is only available for a small subset of patients, and all the other patients are managed conservatively with supportive treatment. And hydroxyurea is a FDA-approved cytotoxic drug that interrupts DNA synthesis by inhibiting ribonucleotide reductase enzyme. Initially, this was used to treat cancers. Then, with the discovery of its ability to upregulate gamma globulin, it was introduced into the standard management of sickle cell anemia, and eventually several studies have concluded that it has beneficial effects in beta thalassemia as well. However, a recent Cochrane review and a meta-analysis study concluded that there is not enough evidence from randomized controlled trial to support this conclusion. So our study is aimed to fill this void in the knowledge. The general objective of the study is to determine the efficacy and safety of oral hydroxyurea in patients with transfusion-dependent beta thalassemia, and to determine the effects on the pre-transfusion hemoglobin level and transfusion requirement, safety, acceptability, and tolerability of hydroxyurea are our special objectives. This is a phase 3 randomized double-blind placebo-controlled clinical trial conducted at the Adult and Adolescent Thalassemia Center of North Colombo Teaching Hospital, Ragama, on patients aged over 12 years. And the participants, data collectors, outcome adjudicated, and data analysis are blind regarding the treatment until the final analysis of data is available. We included patients with confirmed genotype of homozygous or compound heterozygous beta thalassemia who had more than 10 transfusions during the preceding year. We excluded patients with chronic liver disease, kidney disease, and with contraindications for hydroxyurea. This gives an overview of our study. After obtaining the consent, we enrolled patients and divided them into randomized them into two groups, the intervention group and the control group. The intervention group received hydroxyurea and the control group received the placebo. Duration of the intervention is 6 months. During this period, we assess patients monthly, and a physical examination was done by a medical officer. Blood samples were taken for relevant investigations. And if they have shown any signs of hematological toxicity or clinical toxicity, we discontinued the trial. And as you can see, there's no significant difference between the placebo and the drug. So ethical approval has been obtained by the ethics committee at Raga Medical Faculty. And this trial has been registered at Sri Lanka Clinical Trial Registry. A total of 41 patients participated in our study. Out of them, 20 patients received the hydroxyurea and 21 patients received the placebo treatment. 3 patients were discontinued. 2 who received hydroxyurea were discontinued due to a development of thrombocytopenia, and 1 patient who received the placebo developed a rash. No significant difference in socio-demographic and clinical characteristics between the intervention and the placebo group was noticed after the data analysis. No serious side effects were reported during this period. As you can see, the mean pre-transfusion hemoglobin level and mean fetal hemoglobin percentage were higher in intervention group compared to the placebo group, and the transfused blood volume is lower in intervention group. However, these changes are not statistically significant. Based on the elevation of fetal hemoglobin, we identified 6 patients as hydroxyurea responders. So the responders had higher mean pre-transfusion hemoglobin level compared to the non-responders and the placebo group, and their transfused blood volume is lower than both groups. However, the difference between the transfused blood volume in responders and the placebo group is statistically significant. After the data analysis, we came to a conclusion that 1/3 of patients responded to hydroxyurea treatment requiring 20% less blood compared to the controls, and no serious side effects were reported. Thank you.
The paper is now open for discussion. You have 3 minutes.
Study, but numbers are very small, isn't it?
Actually, madam, this is a part of ongoing trial.
And out of the 20%, out of the 20, only 3 patients, isn't it?
Yes.
20 patients, only 3 showed response.
Six patients. We identified as responders. There are 3 patients who had we had to discontinue.
Presumably, this must be given continuously, no? The medication.
Yeah, yes.
So, for life, basically it's for life.
Hydroxyurea. Yes, sir. These patients, as a trial, we gave hydroxyurea for that 6 month period. Then we have started following them up for another 6 months to assess the long term effects of hydroxyurea.
So, they're still on the medication?
No. We have discontinued them after 6 months, and we are planning to assess them for another 6 months after discontinuing either hydroxyurea or the placebo to monitor any long-term effects.
So how long can these patients be on hydroxyurea on the long-term
effects? Actually, sir, the longest trial that has been conducted so far is a study to assess long-term effects of hydroxyurea in side effects for 17 years. So they have conducted the study selecting about 300 patients, and they have come to a conclusion that hydroxyurea is associated with increased survival of beta thalassemia patients.
And they receive lesser blood transfusions also.
Yes.
So during your study, did any of the placebo or the hydroxyurea group receive any blood transfusion during
actually,
that period?
Sir, yeah, since we have selected transfusion dependent patients, we didn't interfere their standard management. So these patients are on regular transfusion on monthly basis or 3 weeks basis. So they received their standard management. All the decisions were taken by the medical staff at the center. So that's why we couldn't identify any significant difference fetal hemoglobin level, because their fetal hemoglobin levels are unreliable due to regular transfusions.
In the absence of any other questions, thank you very, very much.